Namaste. Start your day with this beautiful 30-minute energizing and elevating yoga sequence filled with a mixture of stretches, balance, and strengthening poses, the perfect way to kickstart the morning. So let's get started. Begin in Samasthiti, allowing ourselves to ground ourselves. Inhale and exhale, rolling the shoulders back. Nice and steady, opening up. And then gently coming into Pranamasana, folding your hands in prayer, connecting yourself to the divine, bowing your head down. As you open your eyes and inhale, raise both the hands up into Urdhva Hastasana, making a wide circle come down. Two. Lovely. Keep going. Open up. Three. Fantastic. Four. Feel the stretch. Raise yourself as much as you can. Five. Perfect. Six, with the breath, inhale up and exhale down. Seven, lovely. Eight, nine, last one, you can do it. And 10. Coming back to center, interlock the hands above the head this time. Raise the heels up and come down. Two, keep going. Three, lovely. Four, balance yourself. Five, six, seven, fantastic. Eight, keep going. Nine, and 10. Ardha Uttanasana, dynamic variation, forward fold, perfect. And inhale, come back up, raise yourself. Exhale, forward fold, inhale up. Keep going at your own pace as you breathe in, going up, and breathe out, coming down. Allowing your body to open up, feel the stretch. Lovely. Open up, feel the stretch in your lower back, hamstrings, back of your knees, breathe with the breath, coordinating the body and the breath. Inhale up, exhale down, interlock the hands behind your back, relax here for a few counts, breathing in and breathing out, allowing yourself to open up the body, feeling the stretch, releasing any stagnant energies. Inhale, come up and make your way into some beautiful hip rotations. Exhale back, inhale to the front. Keep breathing and keep going. Lovely. Breathe. And switch sides. Open up those hips. Fantastic. Feel the stretch. As deep as you can go today. And then back to center. Allowing ourselves to go into some leg raises, hands parallel to the floor. Lovely. Try to keep those legs nice and straight. Engage your core. You can do it. Touching the hand to the leg. And relax. Back to center. Into some neck rotations as you inhale, look up, and exhale, look down at your own pace. Five on each side. Beautiful. Keep going. Feel that tension being released in the neck region. Breathe. With the breath, beautiful. Inhale up, exhale down. and then back to center for some on-the-spot jogging, just raising one heel at a time. Lovely. And if you want, you can add some wrist movements here along with the movements. Beautiful, simple sukshma vyam or joint movements. And relax. Stepping the right foot back into baby lunges. Beautiful. Allowing the knees to slightly bend. Feel those thighs strengthening. Lovely. Go as deep as you can. Don't worry. Whatever's comfortable for you this morning. Exhale down, inhale out. And then switch sides. 10 on each side. Lovely. Exhale down, inhale up. Exhale. And inhale. Keep going at your own pace. Feel that stretch. Feel that strengthening. Beautiful. And then back to center. Allowing to go for some knee rotations, making beautiful circles with the knees this time. In both the directions. And then switch sides once you're comfortable. Lovely. Keep going. Breathe. Exhale and inhale. Gliding into Utkatasana, dynamically done. And exhale, relax. Utkat, relax. Utkat, relax. Exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale, and relax. Preparing yourself for a round of Surya Namaskara. Just close your eyes to center yourself before we glide into this practice. Beautiful. We've warmed up the body. Now we're ready for the sun salutation. Begin in pranamasana. Inhale, raise your hands up into urdhvahastasana. Exhale, keeping the back nice and straight, uttanasana. Inhale, step back, anjaneyasana. Exhale, gliding into falakasana. Inhale, exhale, Shashtang Namaskar. Inhale, Bhujangasana. Exhale, Adho Mukha Svanasana. Breathe. Beautiful. Inhale, step the right foot in the front, Anjaneyasana. Exhale, Uttanasana, forward fold. Inhale, Urdhvahastasana. Exhale, Namaskarasana. And back to Samasthitihi. Breathe. Check. How am I feeling? What am I feeling? Preparing yourself to do the same sequence on the other side. Pranamasana. Urdhvahastasana. Uttanasana. Step back, Anjaneyasana. Other leg, into Falakasana. Shashtang Namaskar, knees, chin, chest. Bhujangasana. Adho Mukha Svanasana. Left leg comes in the front, Anjaneyasana. Uttanasana. Breathe. Urdhvahastasana. Pranamasana or Namaskarasana. And relax. Samasthitihi. Breathe. And once again, check. Allowing your palms to face upwards to receive that higher divine energy. Allow yourself to receive that beautiful divine grace. And then when you're comfortable, gliding into Trikonasana, spreading the feet apart, Inhale, raise those arms parallel to the floor, and exhale, extend, making your way into Trikonasana. Breathe as deeply as you can. Open up that chest. And then forward fold into Parshottanasana. Intense forward fold. Feel the stretch in the back of your knees. Once you're comfortable, inhale back up and exhale, making your way to the other side. Nice and gentle, wherever you can reach. If it's the floor, the ankles, whatever it is, you should be comfortable and keep breathing. Gliding into Parshottanasana, beautiful, feel that stretch in the back of the knees, the hamstrings. And then inhale, raise yourself up and relax. Preparing yourself for the Tai Chi stretch. A beautiful massage for the lower back here. Gliding from side to side as you exhale down, inhale up. Bend the knees and make your way from side to side. You should really be feeling that beautiful stretch in the lower back. We're just releasing any tension in the spine here. Beautiful. Keep going. Fantastic. Breathe. And then make your way into Prasarita Padottanasana. Standing wide-legged bend pose. Hands on the floor, and whoever is comfortable, try to place the forehead on the floor and feel that beautiful stretch in the back of your legs. Interlock the hands behind your back for a second variation here. Breathe, go deep, go deep. You can do it. Breathe. Beautiful. And then very gently gliding into Parivrit Prasarita Padottanasana, opening up to one side. And again, keep breathing, making your way to the other side. Lovely. Open up that chest. Feel the stretch. Beautiful. Gently back to center. Micro bend your knees if needed. Make your way up. Inhale. Lovely. And exhale back to Samasthiti. Fantastic. Center yourself. Close your eyes. And now see, how am I feeling? What am I feeling? Breathe before we get into the next sequence of asanas. Making your way into your warrior pose. Spread the feet apart, 3 to 4 feet distance. Inhale, raise the arms parallel to the floor, and exhale, bending the knees. Let's do this dynamically. Beautiful. This is the warrior pose, or Virabhadrasana. And feel that sense of courage and strength within yourself. Beautiful. Try to really make a beautiful 90 degrees with your knees. Gliding into a variation of Uttita Parshottanasana, or the extended side angle pose, both hands in Chin Mudra. Beautiful. Inhale back to center and let's switch sides. Dynamic version of the warrior pose. 10 counts at your own pace. Exhale down and inhale up. Feel that stretch. Feel those muscles work. Feel that courage within your heart. Beautiful. Then glide into Uttita Parshottanasana, extended side angle pose. Breathe as deeply as you can. Bend the knees. Inhale back to center into Samasthiti. Relax. Beautiful. And now check, how are these postures helping me? Can I feel that sense and that flow of energy within my being? Can I use this practice to connect to myself. Let's balance ourselves now through Vrikshasana, or the tree pose. Right side first as you inhale, raise the hands up, balance yourself, lovely. Look ahead of you, beautiful, and hold here. Try to focus your drashti at one spot to help you. Balance yourself, exhale, allowing the knee to come to the front and release. Beautiful, let's do the other side. Left leg, lovely. Ground yourself, raise the hands up above the head. Focus on one spot ahead of you. Lovely, feel that strength, that balance. And release the posture once you're comfortable. Spread the feet apart, slightly, and let's take a few deep inhalations and exhalations with the movements of the hands. A very gentle Tai Chi breathing technique here. Inhale, raise the hands up. Exhale, down. Beautiful. This is a beautiful technique to ground yourself, to center yourself using your breath. Beautiful. Spread the feet apart more, going into around the world, making a beautiful wide circle with the entire body, feeling an overall stretch in the entire body. Five on each side at your own pace. Beautiful, keep going. Look up and down, touch the floor, and then switch the rotation. Lovely. Keep breathing as you inhale up and exhale down. You will really feel that sense of release, that openness within your heart. Lovely. Breathe, don't forget to breathe. And then back to center. Lovely. Samasthiti. Make yourself comfortable. Close your eyes before we go into our seated postures. Just breathe. Open your eyes. Inhale, Urdhvahastasana. Exhale, Uttanasana. Lovely. Step back into Adho Mukha Svanasana. Transition. Now your body is ready, you will be able to go deeper. Hold here. Feel the stretch. Feel the strengthening. Breathe. Beautiful. And once you're comfortable, drop the knees down. Adho Mukha Balasana, spreading the knees as far wide as possible. And then walking your fingers away from you into a wide-legged child pose. This will be beautiful to release any tension in the lower back. And just relax. Take a moment to breathe and relax. Once you're comfortable, inhale, raise your way up into a variation of Paradvaj Asana, a little bit of a twist here, look back, left hand touches the right knee and twist, breathe, look behind you, and then switch sides, nice and gentle. Breathe, don't forget to breathe, breath is the heart of yoga. Back to center into your moon breath, so look up. Interlock your hands behind your back into both chin mudras. Exhale down, touching the forehead to the floor. Inhale, look up. Exhale down, lovely. Inhale up. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale up. Exhale. Inhale, lovely, and relax. Coming onto your knees, preparing ourselves for Ustrasana. Starting off with your hands behind your back, support yourself completely and go as much as you're comfortable today into a baby version of the camel pose. Breathe. Back to center. For those who wish to try stage two, hands on the back of your thighs. Open up that chest. Beautiful. Back to center. Toes tucked in, gliding into your final stage three Ustrasana. You can choose the variation that is more comfortable to you. Breathe, don't forget to breathe. Beautiful. Back to center. And now very gently, preparing yourself for the dancing Ustrasana. Opposite hand to the ankle and open up that chest. Beautiful. This is another variation, a little deeper. If this is too complicated, then you may choose any other stage that is comfortable to you. Back to center. And let's simply twist, looking back, to release any tension in the spine. Well done. Beautiful. And then relax and make your way into Uttan Shishwasana, the puppy pose, keeping the hips nice and raised, allowing the chest to melt into the floor, feeling a beautiful stretch in the shoulders. Beautiful, relax. Inhale, coming back up, and sitting in Virasana. Hero pose. Breathe. Adjust anything if you need to and close your eyes. Gliding down into Supta Virasana. Let's go stage-wise here, allowing yourself to begin with the elbows behind your back on the floor. And for those who are genuinely very comfortable, allow yourself to rest completely on the floor. Feel that stretch in the thighs. Beautiful. Then inhale, raise yourself up, nice and steady. And exhale, relax. Vajrasana. Cross the legs behind you. Straighten them ahead of you. Beautiful. Gliding into a beautiful stretch here for the shoulders, placing both the hands or the arms behind your back and try to lower yourself as much as you can. Straighten those legs and look up. You're going to feel a lovely stretch for your shoulders here. And breathe. Inhale, relax. Coming onto your back into Bhavan Muktasana, the wind releasing pose. Give yourself a nice tight hug here. Relax. Beautiful. If you want, try to touch the forehead to the knees. For those who have any back problems, make beautiful circles with the knees on both the sides, touching both the hands to your knees and just making circles. This will release any tension in the lower back. Breathe. Keep breathing. Beautiful. Making your way into Setu Bandhasana or the bridge pose, before which just relax into your figure four, releasing any remaining tension. And prepare yourself once you're comfortable, coming back to center, nice and steady. Beautiful. And inhale, raise that waist up. Interlock the hands behind your back and raise yourself even higher, making a beautiful bridge with your body. This is going to be lovely to strengthen your back and relax. Lovely. Side to side, release any tension. Gliding into Ek Pad Bhavan Muktasana, one-legged wind releasing pose. Beautiful. Just relax here. Keep breathing. as deeply as you can and feel the stretch in the hips. Once you're comfortable, switch sides. Point the toes. Relax. Relax completely, completely relax. Gliding into Anand Balasana, holding both your big toes. Beautiful. Feel the stretch in your hips, your groin region. Just enjoy in this happy baby pose. Lovely. Making your way into Supta Baddha Konasana, supine butterfly pose. Allowing gravity to do its own work, opening up the hips furthermore. And breathe. Breathe as deeply as you can, as profoundly as you can. Beautiful. Just relax and let go. Flying like a beautiful butterfly in your inner skies. Gliding into Supta Sukhasana. Palms facing upwards to receive the higher divine energy. And just relax. Let go completely. Feeling a deeper opening in the hip region. Beautiful. And then gently switch the side to balance out the body. Beautiful. Just breathe and let go. Deepen your breath. Allow every inhalation and exhalation to be as deep as you can. Making your way into the peaceful lake pose, Shant Sarovar Asana. Knees together, slight distance between both the feet, palms on your belly, and Jalandhara Bandha, meaning chin slightly tucked in. And relax. Relax completely, completely relax. You are free. Just relax. Just be in this moment. For those who are comfortable, extend your legs into your final posture, Shavasana. Palms facing upwards to receive the higher divine energy. Legs at the distance of your mat. And just breathe. Let go completely, connecting to your true self. I am a peaceful, powerful, and pure divine soul. Feet together, interlock your hands above your head as though you've just woken up in the morning, giving yourself a beautiful stretch. Make your way to the side, the right side preferably, and spend a few moments here with yourself, bending the knees into Garbha Truptasana, baby in the womb pose. Keep your eyes closed. Beautiful. And once you're comfortable, raise yourself up into a comfortable prayer position in Sukhasana or Vajrasana. Palms on your knees facing upwards. Close your eyes and spend this beautiful moment with yourself before you start your day, nurturing yourself, your heart, your mind, and your soul. I am divine. I am free. I am Sat, Chit, Anand. Palms together. Bowing down with the immense feeling of gratitude and love. Rubbing your palms together, generate that energy. Give yourself a beautiful massage on the forehead and the cheeks in the upward direction. And looking at both your palms, gently open your eyes with a heightened experience of elevation and tranquility. Namaste. This teacher's training course has been an absolute result of grace. It's been so lovely to see how Pujya Gurudev Shri's grace flows through each and every one of us. I think all the teachers feel so grateful and blessed to be instruments in his hands. It's been so lovely to see this creation, which is a collective energy coming together, and all these teachers having poured their heart and souls into making this teacher's training course, because it's online, self-paced, and especially with everything that's going on in the world, we all feel that sense of emptiness somewhere, or some stress, anxiety, and we all are trying to seek that inner space of calmness, something deeper in life, which yoga can bring.
The SRMD yoga flow is unique in the sense it's not just physical asana. Towards the end of the flow, you really end up with a meditative experience, and that stays with you through the full day.
I've always been into fitness and working out, but SRMD yoga has opened up a whole new perspective for me, a world of stillness, healing, breath, and peace.
We can really add value to our lives in a holistic way through a teacher's training course. And I invite you and everyone to join this movement of self-awareness to be able to truly experience inner growth.